for Ian Rankin.
Thanks very much. I know everybody's here for the free drink and to look at art and to buy art. You're not here to listen to speeches, you're not here for me. But there is a work of art here which I've not actually seen in the flesh yet. I did sit for a portrait. Trevor came to my house and we sat and we talked and he filmed me and then he went away and he worked on it. And it's an augmented reality portrait, which means the secret stuff in there that you can only access if you talk to Trevor. But Trevor will be able to talk about it. Once it's been unveiled, it will be going back to Trevor's stand at E7, and it'll be going up on the wall, and you can then maybe use your phone to activate it and get stuff to happen with it. I don't know, we'll find out. But meantime, it gives me great pleasure to unveil, I don't know, I'm nervous now, to unveil Trevor Jones's portrait of me. You ready? You're going to help me with that?
The augmented reality is image recognition. So once the painting's completed, I basically photograph the painting, and then with our Creative Muse platform, augmented reality platform, I upload an image of the painting, and the digital content being the video and digital links. They connect to the cloud very simply, and then with the app Creative Muse, you can scan the painting and it triggers the digital content. I've been working on tech and art collaboration for about 5 years now. You can actually put your phone near to the tag and it triggers the digital content, so then you can find out what happened when I was painting Ian, what he was talking about with his new book. So it's just near field communication tags embedded throughout.
Preview night's been very well attended. It's been probably a lot busier than we expected. There's, I think, about 2,000 people being through the doors. I think people nowadays, they've kind of got it noted in their calendar. The preview night is now an event that people do look forward to. The art fair has grown from quite humble beginnings, I suppose, and now we have, we're just short of 70 galleries. Galleries from all around the UK, Ireland, this year we've got Denmark and the USA, and they're bringing obviously artists from their native countries, but they're also bringing artists from, well, the gallery we've got from Denmark, he's got artists from Sweden, he's got artists from all over Scandinavia, and that's great for us to have, you know, because you don't normally see the work in Edinburgh or Scotland, so to have it here for 3 days only under the one roof, you know, I mean, it's a perfect opportunity for people to come along and buy art they would never normally get the chance to see. I was talking to a chap from the wrapping station there, and he reckons that there's been around 250 pieces sold so far. I know that a lot of galleries have had a sale or two. There's paintings, there's sculpture, there's glass, there's ceramics, there's a bit of everything, I think, that's been going out the door. Just a lot of things wrapped, which is great. I think by the look of tonight, we could be on for a record year.